Hey guys, Eric Baer here on the set of Belonging. We're shooting the MetaHuman mocap monologues for Hyperwatt. And Faceware just sent us this gigantic box. It arrived by FedEx today so that we can capture multiple actors at once. And I figured before we got started, I'd show you what's inside and before the guys figure out how this thing works. It's like 1,000,000 pounds. So we open up there. First thing we get is this beautiful kind of cartoon user manual by Kat Rodriguez. Her own drawings. She is the mastermind of support there. This is wonderful drawings. Makes it easy for a person like me who can't read, because I can just follow the pictures and do everything. Luckily, I'm not the one who has to figure it out. But these guys who actually can read less than I can do that. And then the first big thing we see right off the bat are a collection of shells. You know, these beautiful blue shells. Now, I don't know who this is for. It's like those kind of really small monkey people, or, you know, kind of right out of the womb sizes. And my guess is that this looks like kind of a normal human, and this looks like some child, and then this was the infant. But in reality, this is pretty loose on me, even if I were to crank it up. So there's no way that my intuition is right. It has a crank clasp on the back and a quick release. So clearly, I am not an adult. I am of this size, maybe. There's no way. I mean, this is actually looks like it's actually smaller than my head. Maybe we'll try that on my golden doodle later, which leaves the Goldilocks option of just the middle to fit on me. And, you know, I was worried about a full cap helmet, because I've been using the standard deviation helmet, which is insanely light, and this is much better than I imagined. You know, like I might just wear it to get stuff done. I feel like I'm in Tron. Like I want these guys to build me a metaverse of Tron, and then I can live in that for a while. Probably without the camera on it. So what's next? Got some straps of some sort. We've got a bat belt with a wireless connector. We'll see what's next for that guy. There is a dial of some sort and a switch. So at least we have nice hardware user interface to something. Don't know what yet. There's a big rack unit. Maybe these are for hard drives. Transport controls and a ton of BNCs and mic inputs, a couple of HDMI out. Seems like we're getting set up for a major operation. You know, one of the things that's real interesting to me about being able to try this is the sync between the audio and the video. Right now we have about a quarter second lag on our standard deviation helmet because the standard deviation is going wireless and our audio feed is coming, you know, off our boom and our lav on the other system. It's a great signal and it runs through a Mac and then feeds over to the PC, joins the signal from the standard deviation, but because one's wired, one's wireless, we've got a little bit of lag. So we haven't tested that yet with wired to wired to see if that eliminates that issue. But, you know, that's for next time. So this unit multiplexes everything, I'm told, at once. And we also get start-stop controls to sync with the Xsense system. So everything is locked from the get-go. which would, you know, make everybody's life easier. All right, what's next? HDMI cables. More cables, power, and BNC cables. A mirror, because actors always like to have mirrors. Surely that's why it's there. You know, got some great makeup tips for you actors in terms of dampening the shine, and we can do that in another session. We got a UTEP SDI in. Some tools. I don't even know what that is on the end of that guy. But I know that this comic book's gonna tell us what to do with it. Some clamps, it looks like, for putting the arms together. Another local cable. Antennae. All right, set these tools aside. Surely they do something that we don't know. So we're one layer in. Ah, yes, the all-important mount, which is incredibly light. It's, it feels hollow. So, you know, and it's not as far as I thought it might be. You know, I've had concerns about the fisheye view that we get if we're too close up, but it turns out I've got a fairly large nose, which means in order to see my eyes and lips, we need to pull away far enough. So that'll be a good test. Clamps for after hours fun. Makeup wipes. Neutrogena, so that's quality. And what else do we have? Who knew? Come with makeup kit. Yeah. Black and white eyeliner. So if we were to do dot patterns and you've got medium light tone skin, or if you've got a dark tone skin, I'm just guessing. Pencil sharpener. It's amazing. You get a helmet with a pencil sharpener. Okay. What else have we got in here? Now we have some bags. Feels like extra foam to fit on different size heads. It's great that they come with three different shells. Yeah, so we've got shells. Foams. So it could be, if my head didn't fit this, or if your head was in between sizes, you could make it fit. So this is for the large. There's a bag for the small and for the medium. Okay? Kind of what you'd hope for. What else we got? Teradek. Some sort of a transmitter. Looks like we've got a bunch of wire antenna attachments, and then some BNCs, bunch of power bricks. I know what those guys are all for. Maybe this is another AJA unit. Test drive. Don't know. Maybe it's a drive. Where that will go. Another local cable. Another power brick. What else do we got in here? A couple of box things. Batteries. Yep, lithium ion batteries. Because, you know, Bat belt wouldn't be complete if you didn't weigh it down with some heavy batteries. Oh, these are not as bad as I thought. A lot smaller than the box that it's in. So it'll be interesting to see how these fasten onto the belt without weighing me down as an actor. All right, what else do we have? We've got a tiny little Pelican box. I love Pelican boxes. They're kind of, you know, some people have a thing for, you know, whatever. Got a thing for Pelican boxes. Sort of really like them in all different sizes. And in here, yes, as one might guess, is the camera to protect that on a unified cable, which is nice so that it's all there. And this guy, let's see, is this a lens cap? I can give you a little bit of a view into that. Give it to the side view with two lights on either side. Be curious, and it has a diffuser on it, so maybe that helps with reducing shine on the face. And then it comes into some sort of a connector that's gonna go with a nice firm Velcro for the belt pack. And what else we got? And then I think we're down to the bottom. A display for local reference to the video coming out. And are there any other layers here? No, that's it. We've got it all unpacked. And now I'm gonna turn it over to the guys to see if they can get it all plugged in. And I'll see you on the other side.